They're getting ready. But let's go to Abuja. Coach Bala Nkeu, the coach of the Flamingos, the national under 17 women's team, is standing by to talk to us. Good morning, Coach, and welcome to the program.
Good morning.
Okay, Coach, the South African team, they've arrived the country. They came in on Wednesday. They've had a training session. Does this team worry you in any way?
No. There's no issue of worry. At least if you have a match, you have the liberty to arrive at the match venue any time you want, depending on your strength. So if they decided to come to Nigeria a week before the match, nobody stopped them. So at least when we are going to South Africa too, it depends on how many days we want, and so. There's no problem about their arrival to Nigeria. They are coming to play a match, and we are ready for the match.
Your team demolished the Baby Gladiators of Namibia on goals aggregate. It was 9-0. Are you under any form of pressure? Because as soon as that, if you can defeat Namibia 9-0, we're also expecting some high-scoring, game against South Africa.
Well, the Namibia match is put aside already. We are not talking of that one already. This one is another match, and like I have to say right now, any team you want to play, you don't start counting goals outside the field of play. You have to wait for 90 minutes, and then your effort will give you the number of goals you want. We did not score Namibia because we had more power than them. We scored Namibia because we played well and we had the luck to score as much goals as possible.
That's right.
So we definitely want to play well against South Africa, and it will not depend the number of goals got as this thing that we'll have.
Okay, you sound so confident, and that's definitely the Flamingos will have a better, opportunity. Stands a better chance of beating the South Africans. Especially judging from what happened against Namibia. Why are you so confident? What are you telling the girls?
Well, the truth is, like the proverb used to say, is, as you make your bed, so you lie on it. I know too well that we have trained enough. I've given them ideas, not even if it is not 100%, but I know it's close to 95% for them to be able to get something. And that is why I speak, because I believe that at least if they can work with what we have done, they can get the result we want. So definitely after you have done much on your players, you have the confidence because you know they will deliver you. So definitely if you work after doing extensive work and they don't respond or reciprocate, you will not be happy. So I'm confident because I know we've done a lot. I expect a lot from them. So definitely, I think by tomorrow, at the end of 90 minutes, we still assure Nigerians that they'll be happy with what they will see.
Okay, we definitely can't wait. 4 p.m., that's the time, Abuja, tomorrow at the Abuja National Stadium. So, Nigerian fans, you can actually go there and cheer the girls to victory.
Okay, Coach, finally, before we let you go, talk to us about the quality of this team that is giving you so much confidence. Some of the players are not known. Tell us about the quality in the team.
Yeah, some of them are not known because they are actually from academy, and they started, if I may say, any good play or whatever I would like to call it, and they exposed football. They started it in the national team because when they started, they came, a lot of them came in from the academy and they were looking confused. Because they didn't actually know what is happening. But the joy I have over them is that they are meeting up quick with whatever we are doing. They are meeting up very, very quick, and that is actually what is giving one confidence to talk. Whatever you are teaching them, they are responding quickly. And I think with that, you can always be guaranteed that they will give you a good result.
That's right. And on our part, we'll do all we can to support your team. Thank you so much, Coach Bala Nkeu, for speaking to us. Thank you. That's what it is.
Support is all they need. They're ready. They're just waiting for 4 p.m. tomorrow.
With the Flamingos, you see, like, I can go to sleep, give you a call and say,
what's
the result? Okay. And with the four cornets, I can maybe watch the first half and then
go to sleep. With the Super Falcons?
With the Super Falcons.
Not anymore.
Not anymore, Cecilia, because, oh my goodness. The fact that they've missed out on two Olympics.
I actually missed those days.
Back to back. I know that again tells us
after
that
the African Women's Championship just went down.
Just like the Flamingos now. We see we can see right there that that's the future.
Mm-hmm. We've been in camp 4 weeks now.
There. Good. And they've not missed out of the FIFA Women's Under 17 World Cup since 2008. Now that's some consistency. Look at this Super Falcons team and say to yourself, why can't we start getting players move
that's
from
what
the
they've
17
been doing. Yes,
to the
that's
20?
Check
but Cecilia, we keep seeing recurring names
in the four corners.
Let's not go there with the four corners. The same players. This player will finish playing the Under 20 World Cup. We'll see the player again going for the next edition, and then we'll start asking questions. I'm saying what has happened with the Super Falcons is a wake-up call. It's a wake-up call to us that a lot of African countries are getting better. We should do the same.
Austin, I think the problem with the Super Falcons has nothing to do with the players at all. The problem with the Super Falcons has to do with administration.
One.
Now, when you feel you can just tinker with the team or with the coaching crew anytime you feel like, it tells on the girls. The psychology of you or of taking care of the girls is different from the boys. Now, you have a coach who's been with these girls for a very long time and all that, and they came back from the World Cup. Fine, their performance wasn't wonderful, but he won the African Women's Championship for you, right?
Yeah.
Now, you went to the World Cup. The preparations were, we know preparations was nothing to write home about. We all know that. I mean, 2 weeks hurriedly, nothing. You went to Canada, okay, you played two friendlies, and you expect your team to beat United States, Sweden,
Australia.
Cecilia. How?
Okay, fine. That's one.
Coach and when you Cecilia came back, you tell the coach, okay, pack your bag and go. The head coach, and you left the team with the assistant coach to that same team that went to Canada.
And that's because they are thinking, oh, the Super Falcons in Africa. We'll just go and then we'll beat them.
Austin,
a lot of people are getting ready. But let's also mention that it's important. While we tackle administrative problems, we should also check players' welfare. Where's the league? Nobody's talking about the league
it
at
hasn't
the moment.
Started.
That's exactly. It hasn't started.
It's supposed to start on the 20th.
So
we are still waiting.
So, but what are the incentives?
At least something.
What are the incentives in place? Where is the board? We're waiting for a board.
When will the election? Will they still have
guiding
election?
Guiding women's football in Nigeria, because now it's obvious that we have the talent.
The committee was set up to actually. Okay. We'll have a Super Falcons Day, not today, right?
Okay, we should have a show.
We'll have a show on Super Falcons, but not today.